The housing crisis in the U.S. today is more of a mortgage loan crisis, as home loans were offered over the past 15 years to borrowers who would have been classified as high risk. The result was a massive increase in the number of people defaulting on their home loans. At the heart of this economic debacle was the federal government, creating an artificial mortgage funding market through the Federal Home Loan Mortgage Corporation and the Federal National Mortgage Association, better known as Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae, respectively. These two agencies had been in place for decades, establishing home loan guidelines in an effort to protect the mortgage lending market by guaranteeing assets if a borrower were to default on a loan. This minimized risk for banks and lending institutions, which meant they could extend loans to potentially risky borrowers. Over the years, this process was abused and led to mortgage approvals for people who simply could not meet the obligations of a home loan. With high-risk borrowers in over their heads on home purchases, many had to default, leaving lenders holding the bag as Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac were overextending themselves to cover their losses. Ultimately, taxpayer funds were needed to shore up these ailing banks, and the public sentiment demanded that Freddie Mae and Fannie Mac tighten its mortgage lending requirements. With the housing market in chaos and financial institutions hemorrhaging money, Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae issued guidelines for banks and mortgage lending companies, requiring them to adhere more strictly to government regulations. While few new regulations had been handed down, sticking closely with government meant prospective home buyers now had to present a much more stable financial background in order to be approved for a home loan. Borrowers now had to show that they could make good on their mortgage agreement. Though the environment for home buyers is a bit tougher to negotiate, there is still a home loan market for people with bad credit. The prospective home buyer needs to be aware that, without a perfect credit score, there is no low-cost, low-interest deal. Those are reserved for ideal borrowers. But with a little extra effort and due diligence, a home loan with a reasonable terms and interest rates can be found. In these hard economic times, a lender is looking at more than just a credit score. They're looking for someone who has a good debt-to-income ratio, a reliable source of income, as well as some savings and a good history of paying their debts. Just because a potential home buyer has less than perfect credit doesn't mean they'll be left out in the cold in the home loan market. Federal Mortgage Services, financing you need for the home of your dreams.